My video. Go.
Hey, everybody.
Hi.
Once again, we're in another home bedroom.
That's
a little strange.
Me and
typical.
Misty just hanging out in the bedroom.
Typical. Can you sit on that side? Like, I'll surf you.
You guys, today is, we're not just hanging out in a bedroom. We're gonna be doing this is the best show.
It is. We're really excited about this show because it's all about hospitality and guests coming to your home because the holidays are coming and guests are coming in. And how do we make your guests feel warm and welcoming just like they do in our Nailed It studio, right?
Can we make your guests feel as good as they feel in Nailed It? Maybe.
I think we can. And I bet you have some great tips that you would love to share with everybody as well. But we have some tips that we like to do. Well, I'll say, Darby and I do this for our guests.
Let's just lay something out there. If you're one of my guests,
you don't get this treatment.
This is not happening when you come to my house. However, in the perfect world, you guys will get this.
We have been known to be called the Grant B&B. It has happened. I'm sure it's happened at the Copelands as well. So let me tell you some of the things that we've done to help your guests feel very warm and welcoming when they come to your home this holiday season. So one, and this really, really a great idea, is a basket of love.
Give them a room.
Give them a room with a bed. Room with a bed is important. And actually, I'll start on the bed because that was important. Having a light blanket. Or an extra blanket for them is important because some people get taken notes. Some people are colder and hotter, so having a light and a heavier blanket is important. Having different types of pillows, so like a firm and a soft or a down pillow is always important. I always have three kinds of pillows on my bed because I'm someone who sleeps with lots of pillows, so I assume guests do too. So I like lots of pillows. That's important. And then having like some type of basket full of toiletries. Now I'm gonna get your throat thing. Having, you know, like things that you may leave behind or forgot to pack, like the toothbrush. This is something she needs now. She needs, go ahead and start that now. You know, toothbrushes. I mean, Shannon always leaves her toothbrush and never brings it.
Every hotel we go to, I'm like, I'm going to go to the front desk. I forgot my toothbrush.
Those are important. Deodorant. Who doesn't forget a deodorant? Like, that's just something. It's typical. Something that I love that Darby put in here is little flashlights because it is a new room. You may not know where the lights are in the middle of the night, you know, if you wake up and forget where you are, to have some kind of like little flashlight, totally important.
So sweet.
If you think about your guests, and the age kids that are coming, or is it a man or a woman, having like men shampoo or, baby shampoos, things like that, that's important. Makeup wipes. Totally, totally important because that is something that I do forget and it doesn't ruin your pillows. It is so key. Kind of gives them the hint to take their makeup off before you lay on my bed. Right?
Yes.
So this is important. And one thing that I like to do with my guests is have like a little gift for them. So what better way than to have like a small little sign from where they're visiting from, you know, like they're coming here and they can take this home. So this one's a Baxter Village one and they can take that home. So cute little gift. Darby likes to give, I was trying to think of where the little, she has a drawer full of goodies in here.
Please come on.
So she has this little cute drawer full of a notepad for her guests to take notes when they think of things. She has like a little first aid kit.
For when they fell off the bed because they didn't have the flashlight.
A little sewing kit because they lost a button when they were here and they don't have to ask for something. Now that's pretty cool in you. So even having an extra charger is important here. Some of her tips that she likes to say is don't put a live plant or if it's live, not something that's not flowery, anything like that, because they may have an allergy, but having a succulent in the room is really nice and it adds to. So having something like that, even having, one of the things Darby likes to do is have a welcome note, like a little note.
Handwritten.
Handwritten little welcome note.
Let them know the code to your door.
Yes, I think it's cool. So, do you want to, you have enough voice to share what we've done?
We are so excited about this, you guys.
This is pretty exciting.
One thing with Nailed It is that we want to give you guys things that work in your life, in your home, the things that you really need. So, we actually teamed up with Amy, our designer, and we are offering you guys a free printable. Now, the printables are not like any, these printables are awesome. So, we're going to talk through a little bit
about custom designed.
What they're doing. Yep, they're hand-drawn. Go ahead and zoom in on that because I want you to see
it. So I'll come a little closer. This is one form of it. This is a great way when you have guests, they obviously they want to get on your network and need your password if you have a guest password for your Wi-Fi, right? That's something everyone asks in your house. So to have that information already here by their bedside is fantastic. You can also, I'm going to take that one away. You can actually download your own QR code that links them directly to your passcode. And we're going to give you directions on how to do this. Is that not cool or what?
Super easy too. So all you guys need is, of course, a printer and paper, and then you guys can print them right out. And the cool thing is that we've designed three options for you. So you might have guests that want the network and the password. You might have a guest that wants the QR code.
You'll have that. But you also attach to every one of the printables is a cute little sign. This one says make yourself at home that you can put inside
or even
that
on the bed.
Cute little basket or put on here or put by their door and you can write a little something right there. So how cute is that?
It looks so you can even get like different obviously with holidays coming up and Christmas you could even do a cute Christmas one, but these are done all on different types of papers. There are even a couple like you can go do it see-through and get a really cool frame for that. But here's the thing about these frames. So the frame that we're showing you guys, these are something you can go into your Nailed It studio near you, mm-hmm. let them know you downloaded the printable on the live and that you guys want a block to hold the printable on so then you have a place to kind of put it on. So stop in your Nailed It studio, let them know that you want to get your block and you guys can go make one of these.
And it looks nice and
looks so cute.
And cute. How cute is that, buddy? You will be definitely, your guests will be so impressed by having something like this. And you're in theirs. And I love that there's a holiday one so you can switch it out.
I mean, this look how cute. Like, what an honor for your guests to come in and see something so cute for them.
I love it.
Isn't that awesome, you guys? This is such a great way for you guys to take that up a notch. And this is adorable. I just love it.
And we're giving this to you free. So let me tell you how to get it. If you are not a member of our Nailed It crew, you need to go right now and ask to join. It is a private group of VIP DIYers where we give you even more information on all of our great lives and actually even more great design
tips
and tricks and things for your home. So go ahead and ask to be a member. And if you're a member, you're going to get this download free. Yay. Three choices free for you and the directions on how to make your own QR code.
Yeah. So. Don't forget, too, we want to talk to you guys about a little bit of ambiance in the room as well, is to take the opportunity to make a sign that reminds your guests this is the guest room.
Be our guest is one of the
most adorable little phrases when you walk in and it says that. I think everybody goes back to, like, knowing where that comes from and just
Disney.
Knowing
how... Downloaded Disney Plus this week.
Yeah, if you're even tuning in because you're too busy on Disney Plus.
And how cute, but, if this was hanging, I don't want to hang it right now, but... How cute is that hanging above the bed?
Just to show them, like you want them to be their guest. And I think the most important thing that you, and you do it really well, but just making people feel like when they're there, they're not in. Like, you can,
I mean, you know,
this is why
throw it around.
We just get the first aid kit while we finish. So this is why we just leave this out.
So, leave that out for me.
As I was giving you a compliment as she threw things at me. Just making a guest feel like when they come there that there's no worries, there's no trouble. They're not putting you out. You're giving them a warm environment, a welcoming environment.
Absolutely.
Just like when you walk in and Nailed It, and we want you guys to feel that same feeling. So it's
even
nice.
If you can't see your guests, sometimes guests come to visit you for other reasons than just to visit you. They come because you're a free place to stay when they've got business meetings or other things. How nice is it to be able to come to someone's home and have all of these essentials and things here and they feel great and welcoming and being able to have some muffins downstairs for them when they wake up in the morning. That's always important to me.
I
have breakfast ready for someone. So a little coffee station and everything ready to go.
In my house. So. I feel like we're setting the standard a little high. No, but either way, I would, even if I do nothing like this and it's not my thing, but I would totally go and get our printable and our woodblock, mm-hmm. because I think this just sends a really great message of, like, taking that
extra
step.
And that's even cute. It doesn't have to be in a guest room. If you don't have a guest room, people come to your house for dinner. They come and hang out. You could have this somewhere in your home, especially in the entryway.
Our babysitter always does that. Mm-hmm. She's like, remind me the password. I'm like, oh, maybe I need to get out of this.
Yeah, absolutely. Have it on your entryway table or something like that, so when people come to enter, they can have all your information right there. So I think it's fantastic. We nailed it.
I did nothing.
You did. I love it. So get to your closest and nearest Nailed It studio to make your block. Go ahead and go to the Nailed It crew. Ask to become a member if you're not, and then have it downloaded. Have your QR and your Wi-Fi information downloaded. We will have that posted at the end of this live. So give us a few minutes, we'll get it posted for you, and then you can have it.
And then you can post your photo below of it sitting in your room.
Oh, I would love that.
I'd love to see what you guys have it, like what it looks like in your home. And which one you choose. One, two, or three. We'll like take to see which one gets the most downloads.
I love it.
Are you guys excited about your printable? Thumbs up if you are.
We like free.
I love free things.
And I like to learn how to do something cool. To have a QR code is really cool.
I like being able to give you guys gifts too, because that's fun. So tune in next week. I guess we're going to go back to, are we going to go back to 10 a.m.? Either way, tune in on Fridays right here on Facebook, and we'll walk you guys through more ways to nail your life. So have a great week, everybody.
Bye, guys.
Bye.